The concept of exit for the PSP is quite simple. People are trapped in the building due to some kind of hazard like earthquake or fire, and it's your job to help them escape. You're Mr. Exit after all. It's a simple puzzle game requiring you to move boxes in certain ways and use certain items in the right order to pave a safe route so that the people in the building can follow you to the exit. The puzzles are quite challenging and the situations are rather unique. Some puzzles really had me thinking a lot, and I was really proud of myself when I solved it. Still, I like to mention that with such simple concept, the game fails in execution of the concept. And I seem to encounter that a lot. I've played a lot of puzzle games in handheld platforms, and unfortunately, for some reason, these developers are able to come up with really amazing concepts, really amazing level designs, but when they finally actually program it, somewhere along the way they kind of messed up in the execution. Like, the gameplay will really be just frustrating to play. One main reason for exit why the gameplay is so, you know, not that fun is that the character Mr. Exit moves way too slowly. I mean, I personally think it's slower than like Castlevania slow. It's really slow. I mean, Mr. Exit can run when you hold down the right shoulder button, but in most of the puzzles, you'll only be able to run like 2 or 3 steps because the gaps and dangerous hazards, so you really don't want to run that much, otherwise you'll fall to your death. The slow gameplay then doesn't make sense why each puzzle has a time limit, and you're timed for it. If the developers were intending to time the performance of the player, it really would have been much wiser to make the gameplay mechanic a bit faster paced. And then there's the platforming. I mean, it's not the worst control, but to say that the controls are responsive is really being overly generous to the game. The game suffers from stiff controls. Jumping over gaps is not fun, and is often quite painful and tedious. Every time you jump or climb over things, the animations again once remind you that this game is just too slow. Like, taking 2 seconds to climb over a 2 feet box is ridiculous. On the later missions, when you have to carry an injured civilian on your back, the game is even slower. And you can't run when you have someone on your back. Really? Man. One last thing I must mention is the AI of the people you rescue. You see, when you rescue someone, you're able to command them to do various things. You can control this mouse pointer thing with your analog knob. With the slow-moving pointer, what's with the slow-moving gameplay? You click on the person of your choice by pressing the triangle button, and then you move it, and then you click on the object or the other person you want him or her to interact with. You can also point to a location on the map for that person to go. And that's where the problem is. The pathfinding programming of the AI has been terribly done in this game. There were a lot of times when I commanded one person I rescued to walk down the stairs. Instead of walking down, she decided to walk over the gap and committed suicide by falling off the gap. And since that mission required me to save 3 people, and there were only 3 people on the mission, I failed that mission because of that. You really have to guide the AI step by step, and this makes it nearly impossible to beat the puzzle in a timely manner. Again, you're timed for this. I don't understand. I've come to these opinions about the game from having played like 60 or so of the game's missions or stages or puzzles or whatever you want to call them. The game has 10 different situations, each situation with 10 stages. So the game has 100 puzzles, and I could not force myself to play all of them. Playing 60 was really enough for me. The game was just boring with the slow gameplay, stiff controls, and stupid AI. Oh, and did I mention slow gameplay? Aside from those 100 stages, well, actually, there's nothing else in this game. That's pretty much it. You can choose to go online and share levels with online friends, I guess, but that feature pretty much sucks. If you like the puzzles, you can attempt to beat the stages at a faster time and earn a higher ranking, but I don't know how that could be fun with such slow-moving characters. And I don't know about you, but being able to beat certain puzzles 5 seconds faster and earning better score for that accomplishment does not really count as replay value to me. This PSP has a library of great puzzle games, and Exit is not one of them. In fact, Exit is one of the most horrible puzzle games released on the PSP. The puzzles stay unique only for so long before the slow-ass gameplay invokes suicidal ideations and homicidal rage all at the same time.